Is that a taking from me by the government? There's no question it's a taking from me by the government. So, no, all taxation is not theft, but it is theft when the government takes money from you with no intent to provide you the benefits of the tax dollars that you have just been separated from.
We have previously encountered Senator Nelson Aldrich in the context of the formation of the Federal Reserve in 1913. Well, it also turns out that Senator Aldrich also played a role in another significant piece of legislation, the 16th Amendment, which states that the Congress shall have power to lay and collect taxes on incomes from whatever source derived, without apportionment among the several states, and without regard to any census or enumeration. Now, an income tax amendment to the Constitution was first proposed by Senator Norris Brown in Nebraska. He submitted two proposals, Senate Resolutions number 25 and 39. However, the amendment proposal finally accepted was Senate Joint Resolution number 40, introduced by Senator Nelson Aldrich of Rhode Island, the Senate Majority Leader and Finance Committee Chairman. The 16th Amendment became part of the Constitution on February 25th, 1913. The 16th Amendment exempted income taxes from the constitutional requirements regarding direct taxes, after income tax on rents, dividends, and interests were considered direct taxes and therefore ruled to be illegal. We can see here the start of the federal income tax in red since 1913. Some would say that the federal income tax on labor has been unlawfully imposed on the American people and kept in place for over a century, contrary to various rulings by the US Supreme Court. But why? And where does the money go? Well, it exists such that successive federal governments can continue to pay the interest on money which, since 1913, they have been obligated to keep borrowing from central bankers, and which the government previously could print independently. Now, of course, the Federal Reserve is the independent agency that controls the money supply. Don't just take my word for it. Here is the former chair of the Federal Reserve, Alan Greenspan.
What is the proper relationship, what should be the proper relationship between a chairman of the Fed and a president of the United States?
Well, first of all, the Federal Reserve is an independent agency, and that means basically that there is no other agency of government which can overrule actions that we take. So long as that is in place and there is no evidence that the administration or the Congress or anybody else is requesting that we do things other than what we think is the appropriate thing, then what the relationships are don't frankly matter.
US President Ronald Reagan requested an investigation authorized in Executive Order 12369 on June 30th, 1982. President Reagan used the now famous phrase, drain the swamp. The focus was waste and inefficiency in the US federal government and became known as the Grace Commission.
I think we were successful. I'll repeat to you today what I said a week ago when I announced Peter's appointment. Be bold. We want your team to work like tireless bloodhounds. Don't leave any stone unturned in your search to root out inefficiency.
Members of his team included 161 top executives, assisted by 2,000 volunteers from the private sector. They contributed more than $75 million worth of their time and resources to examine all major federal programs and agencies. In January 1984, the Grace Commission's work culminated in a report. The conclusion of that report? 1/3 of all income taxes is consumed by waste and inefficiency, 1/3 is not collected due to the underground economy, and 100% of all income taxes are absorbed by interest plus government contributions to transfer payments. In other words, all income tax revenues are gone before one nickel is spent on the services that taxpayers expect from their government.
But it is theft when the government takes money from you with no intent to provide you the benefits of the tax dollars that you have just been separated from.
In essence, all of the income tax that is collected and isn't wasted goes to pay the interest of the money that has been borrowed from unelected central bankers. For more compounded, valuable content, subscribe and like.